Hello students, we will now see a type of absolute loader called as a simple bootstrap loader. You very well know that when a system is switched on, the first program to execute is the operating system. And to load the operating system into main memory, we need a loader. And that loader is bootstrap loader. And this is usually in the ROM. Okay, so as it says, when a computer is first turned on or restarted, a special type of absolute loader, that is a bootstrap loader, loads the first program, which is the operating system, to be run in the main memory. Okay, so this bootstrap loader is itself is written at the zeroth location in the memory. Okay, yeah, and it loads the OS at an address 80 in the memory. Bootstrap loader is saved at a location 0 and it loads the OS at location 80. Okay, there is no header record or control information. The object code is only loaded, that is the OS is just a bundle of object codes. After the loading the OS, the control is transferred to the instruction at address 80. That is, after the bootstrap loads the OS program byte by byte, it goes to the location 80 to start the execution of the program, that is OS program. And OS is told to be read from a device. Here we have taken a device name as F1. So OS is initially in some device, okay, that is, you can say it is initially in a hard drive, stored in a hard drive at some particular location, and it is read by the loader from that particular device and loaded at a location 80 in the main memory. Now, so we have an algorithm for bootstrap loader for SIC XE program here. I'll be telling you how this algorithm works. Now, you need to remember a few things about ASCII codes. Here, I'll tell you a few facts about ASCII codes before proceeding to the program. Guys, here, we know that we have numbers 0 to 9, right? 0 to 9. So, here, the ASCII value of 0 is 48, clear? And this goes on. For example, for 1, it is 49. For 2, it is 50. And it goes up to 9. Okay, fine. Now, you have even characters, which is A, B, C and D. Okay, and ASCII value of A is 65. Okay, 66, 67 and 68. Why is this important? Because we know that object programs consist of these numbers from 0 to 9 and A, B, C, D, E up to F, right? Yeah. So we need to know ASCII numbers of 0 to 9 and ASCII numbers of A to F, that starts from 65. Clear? Okay. Now, that is one thing that you need to remember. And one more thing that you need to remember is here. You know, you very well know that in object program, we had at a particular location, if you know, remember, at 1000 locations, say for example, I have 1A, okay, yeah, and at 1000 location, I have 1A. Again, at 1001, I have some other characters here, okay. Now, this is 1 hexa, this is 1 hexa. Together, they are 4 plus 4, which is 8 bits, which is nothing but 1 byte, okay. Yeah, so this is very well known to you. Character is considered as hexa. So, at a location, we make 2 characters sit and together they are 4 plus 4 bit, which is 8 bit, and then thus they are 1 byte of data. Okay, this is one thing that you need to remember. And one point I had told you that OS program has to be loaded at address 80 in the main memory. That is, 80 is the hexadecimal value, but its decimal value is 128. Okay, whatever you see here, right, in this program, that is hash, that is in decimal value. Even your ASCII values, that is, I said 0 has an ASCII value of 48, right? So this is also in decimal. Okay, this is also in decimal. A had an ASCII value starting from 65, right? This is also a decimal value. If you have to convert this into hexadecimal value, this is going to be 30 in hexadecimal. Clear? Okay, so this is going to be 30 in hexadecimal. And this is going to be 41 in hexadecimal. So remember these things. We will start with the logic of the program, and I hope you remember what A is, right? A is an accumulator, and accumulator is a register where all the current operation results are stored. Okay, yeah. Now let us start with the program. Now see here, as I said, boot, which is the name given to the program, okay, boot starts at zero, starts at location zero. Okay, so let us go through this statement. So we have assumed that the OS is stored in a device by name F1. So the bootstrap loader should read the object code from device F1 and enter into the main memory starting at address 80, which is in hexadecimal, that is 128. Okay, after all the code from the device F1 has been entered into the memory, then the bootstrap executes a jump to address 80, that is, it first copies all the object program onto the main memory starting from address 80. After it has reached the end of file or end of the object program, it again jumps to location 80 to start executing the program that it has just loaded into the main memory. That is, to begin execution of the program that is just loaded. And here we have made use of two registers. One is register A. As I said, accumulator is a register which is very helpful to store all the current calculations. And register X is stored to store the addresses. That is, the initial address is stored at in the register X, and then it is incremented, and as in it is incremented, the next set of object code is stored in X. So X is nothing but like acting like a location register here. Okay, so register X contains the next address to be loaded. Clear? Okay, now let us start with the program. As I said, zero. Yeah, now in the initial place you have to clear the accumulator. Yeah, that is, make its contents zero initially. And then, as I said, the initial address is going to be 80 because we need to load the OS at location 80, and its hexadecimal equivalent, which is given by hash, sorry, it is its decimal equivalent, which is given by hash, is 128. Okay, now you want to, the loader wants to read object program from the device byte by byte, right? So that is read through subroutine by name getc. Okay, and it's given a label loop. Clear? Okay, so jsub jump to the subroutine, that is getc is a subroutine that reads the character from the object program. I will teach you what this is later. Okay, now let us jump to the subroutine getc. So this subroutine is written to read one character from the input device, clear, and convert it in from ASCII code to hexadecimal digit value, and the converted digit value is returned in register A. And when the end of file is read, as I said, when the loader is finished with reading the entire object program and loading it onto the main memory, control is again transferred to the starting address so that the loader starts executing, so that the CPU starts executing the program. Clear? Okay, now let's move on to getc, which reads one character at a time. And this is a command called as test device. And input is a label which is having the details of the input device, which is F1. Okay, so first we have to test the input device whether it is ready or not. If it is equal to zero, then that means that the input device is not yet ready. So if it is equal to zero, that is, if the value is equal to zero, then you have to again go back to getc, that is, check until this device is ready. So if it is not equal to zero, then that is, you have to set some condition code, guys. If it is not equal to zero, then only you can move to the next instruction. Okay, yeah. loop until ready. So let's assume that at this point of time the value is not equal to 0, that is when it starts reading the character. So RD is an instruction which reads from the input device which has a name F1. Now here I was talking about end of the file, right? That is a loader checks if it is at the end of the file, and end of the file is given by a decimal value #4. So you compare if the value, if the character is hexa 4, okay? So if it is 4, so hex 4, why? Because in decimal also it is 4, even in hexa also it is 4. You don't have to convert from 0 to 9 in hexa, right? It is still the same. So if it is 4, that means it is end of the file. So we have just begin with the program, right? So it can't be end of the file this soon. So compare #4. So definitely it is not equal to. Suppose if it is equal to #4, which means you, if jump if equal to, jump to location 80, as I said, if the loader finds that it is at the end of the file, which means it has to jump to start of the program to start executing the program at 80th location. Okay, so compare the character with the end of the file. No, it is not equal to. So we come to this particular instruction. Now as I said, if you remember guys, what did I say? Zero's ASCII value is what is the ASCII value of 0? It is 48, right? And what is the ASCII value of A? It is 65. I will not write the other ASCII values from 0 to 9 and A to F. You can find it by adding one number, okay? Adding one number from the starting, right? Yeah. Now first, here there is a point mentioned here. You have to convert the ASCII code to hexadecimal digit value. So from 0 to 9, their ASCII codes, when you convert, it should still appear as 0 to 9 itself, okay? And in this one, from A to F, their ASCII codes are 65. So when you see A, it has to be represented by 10, okay? When you see B, it has to be represented by 11. That is what is our idea, okay? So when we see a character from 0 to 9, its value also should be 0 to 9. And when we see a character from A up to F, its corresponding value should be 10, 11, 12, up to 15, okay? So that is what is the idea. So in order to have these values that I mentioned, now you have to do some comparisons, okay? Yeah, and subtractions. Now guys, there is a task here. One second, I'll just erase this. Okay, these are to be erased. Fine, okay. Now, okay, so let us come to this particular instruction. It says you have to compare, because see, the first number that you're taking is 0. So its ASCII value is 48, right? Yeah, okay. So if there is any other special characters, definitely its ASCII value will be lesser than 48, right? And those special characters should be skipped. You want the object programs only from 0 to 9 or consisting of A to F. The rest should be skipped. So if there is any character, definitely its ASCII value will be below 48, right? So you have to compare with the ASCII value of the character. Yeah, and here it is said compared to hex 30. That is, if you convert 48 into hexadecimal value, you get it as 13. Okay, yeah. Compare the character's ASCII value with 48. If it is less than, that is, if less than, go to get C, which means you just skip and read the next character. If the ASCII value of the red character is less than 48, then you have to skip it. That is, you skip it by checking if it is less than. If it is less than, then you'll have to jump to get C subroutine to read the next character. Clear? Okay. If it is not less than 48, that is, if it is 48 or above 48, then what you should do? You should subtract 48 from 8. See guys, now as I said, 0 should be taken as a value 0. So what should you do? You should subtract the ASCII value. That is, you should subtract 48 from the current ASCII value. Okay, so if you subtract 48 from this 48, what do you get? 0. And that is what itself is to be loaded into the main memory. Okay, so subtract 48, subtract hex 30. You don't have to see this, this is just written in the hexa version. Okay, so if it is 48, so let's say if it is 0, okay, 0's ASCII value is 48. And definitely this condition of jump less than is not true. So it subtracts 48 from 48. So 48 from 48, if you subtract, what do you get? It has 0, right? And 0 itself is taken. Let's say it is 1. 1. Okay, 1 is the character that is read. What is its ASCII value? 49. So is the number 49 less than 48? Definitely no. So again, this particular instruction is not executed. So you have to subtract 48 from 49. So when you subtract 48 from 49, what do you get as, guys? 1, right? And 1 itself is to be loaded into the main memory. That is what is explained here. Okay. Okay. No. Okay. So okay, so we are done with subtracting. Okay, this is only for numbers. Now, see, in case you are encountering only numbers, you'll have to subtract 48 for sure. Now, you have to compare it with 10. Okay, why? Because, see here, as in you subtract from 0 to 9. What did I say? From 0 to 9, ASCII value of 0 is 48 and ASCII value of 9 is 57, right? Okay, so if you try to subtract these numbers, okay, it will definitely be less than 10. Okay, yeah, it will definitely be less than 10. Fine, so you take any values, you take 57 also. What if you subtract 57 minus 48? This is going to be how much? It is going to be 9, right? Okay, so if you take even 9, number 9, its ASCII value is going to be 57. So when you subtract 48 from 57, its value is going to be 9. So for all the numbers, the subtraction value is going to be between 0 to 9 itself, and that subtracted value, okay, the result of the subtraction should be compared against 10. So if it is less than 10, definitely it is a number. Okay, so you have to go to return. Return RCEP is nothing but the function that called getC. So which is the function that called getC, guys? Yeah, first time this one, right? So you have to go here, and then the next instruction is executed. I hope I'm clear to you all. I said you will have to first subtract 48, and if the result of the subtraction is less than 10, then definitely it is a number. That means you will have to go return. Return is nothing but return to the subroutine that called it. That is the first get C. You have two get C's in the previous slide. Okay, because why two get C's? If you remember, each address has one hexa each, right? So as I said, I will give you the example of 1A. So for there is a code for the first character get C, and for the second also you have a get C. So two get C's are there for one location. Clear? Okay, now let us, as I said, I will consider 1A. So ASCII value of 1 is going to be how much? 49, right? And if you subtract 48 from 49, you get it as 1, and that 1 is only written. Clear? Okay, now hold on for a second. I will go back to the previous slide. But before that, let me tell you, what is this hash 7? Okay, now guys, let me assume there was A first, okay, and 1 next. Now, coming to this A. So A is red, and it is compared with the hash 4, which is end of the file. No, it is not true. And then it is compared with 48 if it is less than. Definitely ASCII value of AE65. So it can never be less than 48. So we come to this step. And here what happens, we will be subtracting 48 from 65. So if you subtract 48 from 65, what do you get? You get the value as 17, right? Okay, now guys, what did I say? This instruction is for, this instruction works only for numbers, right? So you now you will compare the value, because all these values are stored in accumulators. Okay, you will now compare 17 with 10. Okay, so if 17 is less than 10, then you will have to return to the subroutine that is called. But here 17 is not less than 10, which means it is now going to be a character. Okay, so in order to convert the character into a value, you should subtract 7 more from it, which is 17 minus 7 is going to be 10, and 10 is the value for A, right? Okay, so this is one extra thing that we need to do for characters. Why? Because we will be subtracting 48 from it, and the pending amount is checked against 10. If it is not less than 10, definitely it is going to be a character. And if it has to be a character, we have to subtract 7 more from the result of the subtraction to give you the actual value of the character. Is that clear? And then after this, this is also written sub, because there are two getcs that are called for each of the location here. Okay, so this is how it works. Now, as I said, see, let's assume that you have two getcs. I had taken an object code 1A, right? So this is a getc called for 1, and this is a getc which is called for A. Okay, now as I said you, in 1, what happened when you do the subtraction? What value do you get? You get it as 0, you get it as 1, right? Okay, now what happens is, after the control is passed, that is written subroutine, you go to getc. I'm talking about 1 now. Now this is move in the register. Okay, what is the accumulator 1, accumulator value? Yeah, this is 1, right? What is the value? 0, 0, 0, 1, right? Yes. And here I'll write just 0, 0, 0, 0. The main reason here is, guys, because in object program, these two are considered as 1 byte. But in the main memory, 1 is considered as 1 whole byte, and A is also considered as 1 whole byte. But we want to combine these two as only 1 single byte. That is why we do all these instructions. We execute all these instructions. Okay, moving on. RMO. What is this? The value that is there in the accumulator has to be moved or saved in register S. If you remember, S is a general purpose register which has no particular use. So you can use it for these general purposes now. Okay, now as I said, if you remember just now, I mentioned that in the memory, you need to store each of the character has a half byte, that is 4 bit. That is why you have to combine it together. So to combine it, see guys, this is, I'm writing it for 1, right? Why did I write it for 1? Because this is the value that you obtain after subtraction, and everything is stored in the accumulator register. Now you should move this one to this side and allow A to be stored here, right? So what we do, we shift the bits to the left by 4 bits. That is, if you start from here, This is 1 shift, 2 shift, 3 shift and 4 shift. That is, now you will have a configuration 0, 0, 0, 1, and then this currently becomes empty, or we can write it as 0. That this one, initially it was in the accumulator in this position and it was saved in the S register, but then we have to shift it 4 bits to the left. Now this is 1. Okay. Yeah. Now what about A? A is now going to be read by jumping to the subroutine getc. Okay, now the same thing happens. If you remember, what should you do, guys? First you have to check the character read. I'll just go back. Okay, yeah. One second. Okay, now I'll be staying with the same annotations. Now, as I said, you read A, right? It is compared against 4, end of the file. No, it is not equal to. And it is compared against 48. Okay, so if it is less than 48, then it is some unnecessary special characters, so that has to be skipped. You have to subtract 48 from the ASCII value of A, which is 65. What do you get it as? 17. And you have to compare with 10 to check if it is a number or it is a character. If it is less than 10, then definitely it's going to be a number, but right now it is not going to be less than 10 because the value is 17. So if you subtract 7 from 17, you get it as 10, and 10 is what is stored in the register, right? Okay, so now if I go back to the previous slide, okay, now let us now write for 10. Okay, so let us now write for A. For object code A, in the accumulator we have value 10, right? How do you represent 10, guys? Okay, everything is represented as one byte. That is a problem. You can't load one whole byte onto the object program. You need to take two hexas as one byte. Okay, so 10 will look like this, right? Okay, yeah. ASCII value of A, when subtracted, when after doing all those operations, the value 10 is represented like this. Now, you should move this value to register S using this. Now, shift to the left by 4 bits. What do you do? Shift to the left by 4 bits. Oh, I'm sorry guys, you need not come here. Let me take my words back. Once you return to the subroutine, right, you have to come here because this is the instruction that called, right? Sorry, yeah, this is the instruction that called the second gate C, right? So you have to come here. Okay, fine. Now, so again the same thing. This is not S register because the current value is now stored in accumulator register. This is what is there in accumulator register. Don't get confused with this and this. This is accumulator register and this is the object code A or character A. Now what should you do? You should add two registers. That is, what was there in S earlier? What was there in S earlier? This one. Okay. The contents in S has to be added to the contents in A. Okay, the contents of S has to be added with contents in A and stored in A. So if you add this and this, let me write here, if you add this and this, what are you going to get, guys? You're going to get it as 0, 0, 0, 1, and add the second half, you are going to get it as 0, 1, 0, 1, 0. Okay, so this is the current accumulator value. Every change that is made is stored in the accumulator value. Now, what is this STCH? STCH is nothing but you have to store the character. What is it? 1A, right? This is 1, guys. This is 1, okay? This is 1. And what about this? This is A, right? The second half is A. These two characters should be stored at a location X. What is the current location or value of X? Which is 80, right? So at 80, you need to store the two values, that is 1A, okay? And you have to increment the value of the index register by using the operation TIXR. So this is 80, and in the next location, at the location 81, you will have to read same two other characters from the device F1 and then loop until you reach the end of the file. That is, eventually at the end of the file you will be reaching the end of the file, and that value will match against a hash 4, and when it matches to hash 4, that is, you have to jump to 80 when it becomes equal to, and then start executing the OS program loaded onto the main memory. I hope this is clear to you guys. So let me just recall what you need to do here. Here, the main purpose of having Bootstrap loader program is that is you have object codes, right? You remember object codes at a particular location is considered as 1 byte. That is 1 byte in the sense 2 characters are brought in together, which becomes 1 byte. But when you load a program into the main memory, one single letter or a character or a number is considered as one single byte. It should not happen. So we need to somehow combine the 2 characters as one single byte. So for this, we will have to use a shift to left operation. And also here you need to remember the ASCII values. Okay, that is 48. From 48 you have ASCII values for number 0. And from 65 you have for A. Okay, and 4 is representing end of the file. You will have to first compare any character taken against 48. If the value is less than 48, then definitely it is a special character and that has to be skipped. So in first, any character's ASCII value should be compared against 48. If it is less, skip it. If it is not less than 48, then you have to subtract 48 value from the ASCII value. And if the result is less than 10, then definitely it's a number. If the result is not less than 10, then you will have to subtract 7 more from it, because if it has to be converted, if it is a character, then definitely you have to subtract 7 more from it. Okay, yeah. And here you have 2 getCs. The first getC is for the first hexa value, and the second getC is for the second hexa value. Okay, so the first hexa value that you see will be initially here, and then you use the left operation to put it here. Okay, by saving it in a register S. And for the second hexa value, you call one more getC, and in that getC also you will find that there is some value in the accumulator. Finally, the S value should be added with the A value and then stored in the A value, which will combine the 2 hexas together and stored at a particular location, which is preferably 80. I hope this is clear to you guys. This is a very, very important question. Clear? Thank you.